our topic is respiratory system of Calotes. So most of the reptiles respire through the lungs. So that is a pulmonary respiration. So most of the reptiles, the respiratory organs are the lungs. And so some organisms respiratory organs is the cloaca. So here turtles respire through the cloaca. So cloaca is the respiratory organ in turtles. And some sea snake and some turtles, their respiratory organ is the skin. The skin is the respiratory organ in sea snake and turtles. Here the reptiles having different type of respiratory organs. So that is the most of the reptiles respire through lungs, and some turtles the respiratory organ is the cloaca, and sea snakes, turtles of respiratory organ is the skin. So this type of respiration is called as a cutaneous respiration. So now here, so here the Calotes, the Calotes is the true land breathing reptiles. They are true land breathing organism. So the respiratory organs is the lungs. That is the pulmonary respiration is present in Calotes. So here the Calotes lungs is a, the lungs is not do not having any greater improvement over than amphibians, but the structure is as like as similar as like as amphibians, but it having few developmental changes occurs in lungs of reptiles. So but functionally the lungs of the Calotes is so well developed by comparing with the amphibians. So this is the lungs. Now here the respiratory system initiates or starts with the one pair of external nostrils. So this is the external nostrils. So the external nostrils is so located, arranged very near to the eyes or in front of the eyes. The in front of the eyes, they are very near. So the external nostrils is one pair of external nostrils is present. That external nostrils opens into the so nasal passage. The nasal passage is as like as our so passage. So external nostrils opens into the nasal passage. Now nostril passage opens into the buccal cavity. So it opens into the roof of the buccal cavity through internal nostrils. So now finally it opens into the buccal cavity. So the buccal cavity is having at the base of the tongue, at the base of the bifurcated tongue. This is a bifurcated tongue. There is a longitudinal slit-like structure is present. So this is the longitudinal slit-like structure. So this is a slit-like structure. So this structure is called as a glottis. So here external nostrils opens into the nasal passage. Nasal passage leads or opens into the roof of the buccal cavity. So in the buccal cavity, so the base of the bifurcated tongue region, there is a longitudinal slit-like structure is present, that is called as a glottis. So now the glottis opens into the so larynx. So here the larynx larynx is a box shaped structures. So it is a small box shaped structures. So this larynx is supported or formed by the so total three cricoid bones. So here one pair of arytenoids. So this is the arytenoid bones. So this is a one pair. So this is a larynx. The larynx is a box shaped chamber. So this larynx is formed by one pair of arytenoid cartilage bones and one or single cricoid cartilage bones. So here, so these two bones fuse each other and forms the larynx. Now here, so the posterior part of the arytenoid bones fuses with the cricoid bones. So this is the cricoid bones. It is located at the posterior region and this is the arytenoid bone. So these two arytenoid bones, the posterior region of the arytenoid bones, so fuses with the anterior lateral side of the cricoid bones. This is the anterior region and the lateral side region. So the arytenoid bones fuses with the cricoid bones at the anterior lateral sides. So it is a posterior side of the arytenoid and anterior side of the arytenoid bones. The anterior side of the arytenoid bones fuses with the, so this is the glottis, fuses with the lips of the glottis. The anterior region fuses with the lips of the glottis and posterior region fuses with the anterior lateral side of the cricoid bones. So this is the structure of the larynx. Now, so the larynx is also connected with the two pairs of muscles. So that muscles is, so one muscle is, this is the one is the musculus compressor larynges. So musculus compressor larynges is one pair muscles that is located at the, that is connected to the anterior region of the larynx. So these muscles is act as a sphincters of glottis. This is the glottis. So these muscles regulates the contraction or relaxation of the glottis. So that's why these muscles, musculus compressor larynges muscles, act as a sphincters of glottis. And another pair of muscle is located at the posterior region. So that is musculus dilator larynges. So this muscles is act as a dilation of the larynx. So during dilation of the larynx opens into the trachea. So this is the structure of the larynx. Now finally, the larynx opens into the trachea. So the trachea is, so here the trachea, this is the trachea. The trachea is, so narrow tubular structure. So it is origin from the posterior region of the larynx. So it is a narrow tube and tubular structures. So this trachea is internally supported by complete C-shaped cartilage rings. So here this is supported by complete C-shaped cartilage rings. So these rings, the cartilage or tracheal rings, the tracheal rings is useful, the prevents the collapsing of the trachea when the with high pressure air is enters into the trachea, but there is no tracheal rings, the trachea, that windpipe will collapse. So that's why the tracheal ring prevents the collapsing of the trachea. So that is a trachea. So now this trachea runs downwards and reaches into the thoracic cavity. After reaching into the thoracic cavity, so the trachea bifurcated into two branches, but two narrow branches. That two narrow branches is called as a branchus or branchi. So that is a two branchioles or two branchus. So here the branchus is also supported by cartilaginous rings. So now each branchus enters into the each lung. So that is a, so here the trachea and branchus transports the gases from outside to the lungs, lungs to the outside. That is the function of the trachea and branchus. Now lungs. So here the lungs, the lungs are the one pair of lungs is present. So the lungs are one pair of lungs. That lungs is arranged in thoracic cavity of glottis. So that is a lungs. The lungs is arranged. So this is the heart. So the lungs is arranged one either side of the heart. So this is the heart. Each lung arranged either side of the heart. So the lungs is arranged in thoracic cavity, one on either side of the heart. Now the lungs is elongated sac like structures. So it is a look like as a elongated. The lungs are elongated sac like structures. So here the right lung is slightly larger than the left lung. The right one is slightly larger than left lung. So now the lungs are made with the thin walls. This is the lungs are made with the thin walls, and they are fusiform like structures. The lungs are fusiform like structures. So the lungs is orange in red color. So the lungs is one pair. They are arranged in thoracic cavity either side of the heart. So the lungs is sac like fusiform structures. They are elongated structures. Their walls is very thin walls, fusiform sacs, and orange red in color. So now here internally each lung is divisible into many small chambers. So internally each lung is divisible into many small chambers by incomplete septum. The incomplete septa or incomplete muscles. So the incomplete muscles divides the each lung many small chambers. So these small chambers is called as alveolis. So alveolis. The alveolis is the main site of the respiratory system. So here inside each lung divisible into many small chambers by incomplete septum. So what is the function of these chambers? These small chambers called as a alveolis. The alveolis are the main site of the gases exchange. So now here the oxygen is enters into the lungs. After entering into the lungs, then oxygen enters into the alveolis, and carbon dioxide is released into the outside from alveolis. This is the exchanging part of the lungs. This is the respiratory exchanging part, the main site of the exchanging gases. So that gases exchange will occurs within the alveolis. So that is the alveolis. Now here so the lung is having a distal part and anterior part. So the distal part of the each lung, the distal part is do not having any alveolis or any chambers. So because there is no alveolis, so this absence of the alveolis, so it is not involved in the respiration. And so here, so this length is 1/3 of the whole lung. So the total lung, so the distal part is having 1/3 length. So distal part region, there is no alveolis, there is no involving within the exchange of the gases, or there is no involved in the respiratory system, but this distal part involves in the so reservoir of the residual air. Some air is stored in this region, so that is a act as a reservoir of residual air. So this is the distal part. And the anterior part, the anterior portion is having more number of small alveolis. That's why it is the anterior part is look like as a sacless like structures. The saccules means having more number of alveoles. So that alveolus is this portion, the anterior portion is more active in exchanging of the gases because there is a more number of alveolus. So this portion is, the anterior region is richly supplies the blood because the more blood supplies to the alveolus region. So that alveolus exchanging the gases from blood to the alveolus, alveolus to the blood. So this is the exchanging part. So now mechanism. So the here. So the alveolus are the walls of the alveolus is made with the walls of the alveolus is made with the squamosa epithelium layer or squamosa epithelial cells. That walls is made with the squamosa epithelial cells. This is about lungs. Now mechanism. So who is the mechanism process? So here the chemical composition of the respiration is, the chemical composition of the respiration is similar in all vertebrates, but physical mechanism is different in different organisms. Now, what is the physical mechanism? The physical mechanism is two types. One is the inspiration, another one is the expiration. So what is the inspiration? So inspiration means intaking of atmospheric air is called as a inspiration. So now, so here, now here, so this inspiration expiration is regulated by, controlled by muscles and ribs. That muscles is intercostal muscles and ribs. So here contraction relaxation of the intercostal muscles ribs causes the inspiration expiration. So now first of all we know about the inspiration. During inspiration period, so relaxation of the intercostal muscles or dilation of the intercostal muscles. So this dilation of the intercostal muscle, it rises the ribs. The ribs will rise. So then the ribs generally, so normally the ribs is so having the volume is low. Then during dilation of the intercostal muscles, the ribs will rise and the volume of the thoracic cavity increases. The thoracic cavity volume increases and automatically the pressure will decreases on the lungs. So the lungs volume, the pulmonary volume also increases and the pressure will fall down. So here dilation of the intercostal muscles, ribs rises, then the thoracic volume increases, then same time the lungs will also the lungs volume also increases. Then so after increasing the lungs volume, the pressure will fall down. The pressure is very low. So now, so automatically then the air is comes into the lungs with from high pressure to low pressure. So within the lungs the pressure is very low while comparing outside. The automatically, so outside air is enters into the lungs, it is called as a inspiration. The inspiration is caused by relaxation of the or dilation of the intercostal muscles. Thoracic volume increases, pulmonary volume increases, pressure fall down, air flows into the lungs. That is a inspiration. And expiration, the expiration is caused by the contraction of the intercostal muscles and contraction of the ribs. The ribs is comes its original position. The ribs is comes its original position. So the ribs comes its original position. Then the volume of the thoracic cavity, the thoracic cavity volume decreases. Then automatically So the pressure will be formed on the lungs. The lungs volume is also decreases. So the volume of the thoracic cavity, the volume of the pulmonary cavity decreases, and the pressure inside the lungs, the pressure is increases. So inside the lungs, the air is with high pressure. Then automatically, the high pressure carbon dioxide will be eliminated outside. So that mechanism is, this process is called as expiration. Inspiration, expiration is caused by the relaxation, contraction of the intercostal muscles and ribs. So this is the respiratory system of Kenotes.